did Mark Zuckerberg become the face of stablecoins? How did we get so unlucky? Pitching the merits of a stablecoin is like pitching the merits of a, I don't know, running water, penicillin, higher education. There should be no opposition to the idea of a stablecoin. Stablecoins are a gift to consumers, and they're a gift that benefits all the companies using them. What is so great about a stablecoin? Let's run through a few of the reasons. First, they're cheaper. They're cheaper because stablecoins operate on a single transparent global network. That network, of course, is a blockchain. There's no cheaper way to send a payment to anyone else in the world. They're also faster and more reliable. They come with near instant settlement because, again, the stablecoin is transferred from one party to another on a single network. No hopping across a bunch of different banking and payment networks. When you have to do that, you pay the penalties of low speeds, low transparency, high costs. Your payment has to hop through all those gatekeepers and all those toll collectors. What else? Well, stablecoins are not credit cards. You're transferring direct cash. They're what we call a bearer instrument. And why is that important? Because it addresses one of the biggest issues in the payment industry, and that's fraud. There are no chargebacks with stablecoins. And no chargebacks means that the companies don't have to pass along the fraud costs to their consumers. And that just means you pay less for every payment you make. What would the US Congress have against that? Now, finally, stablecoins are perfect cross-border payment mechanisms. Why? Because you don't have currency conversion costs with stablecoins. You don't need to exchange your 20 US dollars for an equivalent amount of a foreign currency like a euro. Currency conversion costs are like a giant tax on humanity. Currency conversion costs amount to somewhere between 750 billion to 1 trillion annually. So with an $80 trillion in global GDP every year, currency conversion costs are like a hidden tax on whatever you buy from a foreign company. And lastly, let's remember, Facebook is a global business. It has 2 billion customers. 80% of those people are outside of the US. So it makes sense that Facebook would be looking for a better, cheaper, fairer way to facilitate payments for all of those people. We clearly need someone else to help educate the US Congress about the vast positive potential of stablecoins other than Mark Zuckerberg.